1891, and it is a V-nickel. You can barely see the V on there. Just as I was talking about quarters. Man, silver quarter. All right, folks. Just pulled a coin out of this ant hole here and got my hand out of there real quick. But it is a Wheatie 1951D. Ugh. A heck of a lot of ants in there. Those things bite you. Hey, that hurts bad. Everything down here is trying to kill you. That's pretty cool. A nice Wheatie right there, 1951D. Back's a little toasty, but it'll clean up real good. Awesome. I tried a new park this morning for about an hour and a half. It did not turn out very well at all. Best thing I got was a quarter and a penny. Everything else was trash. They had they must have had like Christmas lights up or whatever, and there was hundreds of them all over the place. I mean, I could see them on top of the ground. Every other signal I was getting was a freaking Christmas tree light, so I got out of there. I know there's good stuff where I'm at, so figured I'd come here. And first hole I dug was a zinc, and second hole a Wheatie. All right, pleased with that. All right, guys, let's see what else is in here. And right behind that wheat penny is a 1964 Jefferson nickel. There's the Wheatie there. This hole right here. All right, and I dug a quarter. Modern quarter right next to the wheat penny. Got a signal there. It was the wheat penny, modern quarter, and right here it was 1964 Jefferson. All right guys, on to the next.
All right, guys, I am excited. I see a silver rim. It is a ring. Yes, that is definitely silver. Wow. Awesome, guys. Awesome. That's great. That thing is tiny, too. Let's see if I can even get it on my pinky here. Nope, not even close. Oh, yeah. That's definitely silver. Real high. 75, 76. Wow. That's great. Awesome, guys. Awesome. Nice little piece of shiny. Gotta love it. It's got a little bit of weight to it. Not much. It's pretty light, but you can definitely tell it's got some weight to it. Awesome. Man, this is exciting. I'm doing right along this curb here. That's great. I guess people sit down here and the coins fall off their pocket. They put their hand down, but the ring falls off too. Man, that's awesome. I can't believe this day. I've been here, what, 5-10 minutes? I've already got two fairly old coins, Wheatie and a 64 nickel. I've got a pool tab, and I got a silver ring. So that's great. Very cool. Man, I'm excited. This place is the place that keeps on giving. Alright, guys, let's see what else is in here. Just dug a little earring here. It has a little bit of age to it. It is definitely a junker. But it's still pretty cool. Probably from the 50s, something like that. It's real small and it was down real deep, so. Awesome. Cool, guys. Man, I'm having a good day here. 20 minutes and all this stuff so far. Awesome. Alright, guys. Let's go get some. Alright,
guys. I just got a 1939 Jefferson nickel. That is a second year coin. Only the second year they ever made these things. Awesome. It was deep too. It was giving me a 30s, 40s, and 50s signal. And I dug her up and nice. Saw that date on here, 1939. Very cool, and that is in really good shape.
really good. Not worth too much, like 50 cents, but still cool nonetheless. All right, guys, let's see what else I can pull out of here today. It's only been 25 minutes. Another Jefferson 1964. Come on, let's get into some older ones. Let's get some buffs and bees. All right, let's get some more.
All right, guys, I just got a buffalo at literally right in here. It was sitting right there, and I popped it out right at the grass line. This thing was up under it, and that was sitting right there. I could not believe it. Wow. It's very worn, and I cannot get a year off of it at the moment. I don't think I'm going to. I can see a one, but they all have a one in the beginning. I cannot read it, but that's still great. Nice buffalo. Awesome, guys. It's got a lot of detail in the face, but right there where the date is, these things just lose their date pretty easily. Well, it's got a mint mark of S, I think. I don't know if you can tell, but it does have a mint mark. And I think it's either an S or a D. I think it's an S. Yep, pretty sure that's an S. So whatever it was from San Francisco, and it made it all the way here. I really wish that would have had a date on there, but oh well, you can't win them all, guys. Nice, today's turning out to be a really good day. All right, let's see what else is out here. Got a got silver, I got a 1939 Jefferson, and I got a dateless buffalo. Couple 1964 Jeffersons, and I think that's about it so far. I might have missed something, but yeah, turned out to be a good day. Oh yeah, and I got a weedy. All right, let's see what else. All right,
I just found these two in the same hole. It's a little religious pendant. I guess it was a necklace. I looked for a chain and I did not find one, but I will search again. It was given a very weird signal, so I decided to dig it. And there we go. It says on the back of the little pendant, it says something. Alex and Ari. AlexandAri.com. So I don't know, I'll have to search into what these are. It's pretty modern, but it's still a cool find nonetheless. I think it's made of stainless. It's corroded a lot. Oh, cool, guys. I'm just digging everything today. Everything except for obvious iron. So let's see what else I can get. I just found this little thing. I don't know what it is or what it's off of, but it was giving me silver numbers. Don't know. Weird, it's just like a piece of scrap metal or something, but it's shaped weird. It was deep too. Don't know. Got a cool patina on there though, but I don't know, just junk.
Cool. I got two pennies stuck together. Not Wheaties this time, but 1979 and I don't know what, but cool. They are stuck together. It was giving me silver numbers again. 84, 85, but nope, just two pennies. That's cool though. Alright, guys.
Alright, just got a little Wheatie here. 1957D. Nice shape. Cool, guys. Alright, let's go dig some more. Man, I get so many of these. 1959D. That coin. I get one every time I go out, I swear. First year coin, oh well. Alright, guys, I popped this plug. I saw a bit of shiny fall out from the top here. Oh man, it's back in here. Fell back. Where'd you go? Oh, I turned you off. I just saw it. Where'd you go? Oh man, I buried you down in here. There it is. Oh wow. Okay, what are you? What are you? All right, Rosie. DMET mark. 1948. That is an early one. Nice. Man, I can't get over this day. I am so freaking happy right now, guys. Wow. This spot is just incredibly unbelievable. This signal was 7879. It was popping no VDI and then coming up at 10 plus at 78. So I cannot wait to get this storm coil. I guarantee you there is some deep stuff out here that I just can't get with the stock coil. This didn't have a VDI and I just heard a sharp little pop every now and then. And then the VDI would come on at 79. I thought it was going to be just a really deep wheat penny, but no, it was just deep silver. Oh, wow. Awesome. Deep old silver. Not too old, but look at the soil here. I mean, this stuff just sinks. I can't wait for that storm coil again, and I ordered it a week and a half ago. Should be coming in soon. I mean, I'm gonna go down to Kellyco. I mean, Kellyco's here in Florida, so I'm just gonna go pick it up when they get it in. Sweet, guys. All right. Yes, two silvers today. Got a silver ring and a silver rosy. All right. See what else we can get out of here. All right, 1945 Wheaty. The plug for the silver is right here. And here's the plug. I just pulled Weediata right next to each other around the same time too, so it could have been the same person that dropped it. Just a couple years apart there, so right on. 1945 plane. Alright. Nice, guys.
Alright, guys, check this out. I just went back to silver plug here.
I'm getting another really deep signal. The same one that happened last time. The VDI will pop up 70s, 80s, and then it'll go away. So, and it's right on the edge of that old plug too. So let me take another one here. And let's see what it is. It's hard doing this with one hand. Okay, let me go back over it. Still down in there, real deep. Oh, it is not silver. And it is a memorial. Wow. 1961. Same hole. So that diamond must have been dropped 61 or after, because it was in the same hole as this 1961 D memorial. So gives me a time about when this was dropped. So that's cool. All right, on to the next. All right, guys, I just popped a plug here. 82, 83, 84. Let's see what we got. It's in here. Oh, what's that? Oh, another one of those weird pieces. I do not know what these things are. If you got any idea, let me know, because they are just giving the best signals ever. No idea what these are. Looks like a little paint tray or something, like a little easel thing. Alright, guys. Holy crap. 1909 WD. I can't tell if it's a VDB. Oh man. It looks like there could be something on the bottom, but I don't know. I need a magnifying glass, but I cannot tell. Nonetheless, it's still a $4 coin regardless, but oh man, that would be worth, whew, that'd be awesome if it was that. But 1909, no freaking way was I expecting to find a coin of that date in this place. No way. That is awesome. I saw that date. Where's the S mint mark? But I don't see a mint mark, so I think it's just a regular 1909, but that's still a $4 coin in average condition, and this one is looking really nice. Look at the back. That is looking very good. Alright guys, that is great. Nice. I had to stare at that day for a minute. I'm like, wait, is that a 6? Flipped it over. No, that's a wheat. No. That is great. Oh, this makes my day. If I don't find anything else, I will be happy. Silver ring, silver dime, bunch of Wheaties. This 1909, I got a buffalo, second year Jefferson. Man, today is an awesome day. I am very happy. Alright guys, I'm going to see if I can pull anything else out of here, but I got a big old grin on my face right now. Alright guys, on to the next. Alright, the plug for the 1909 was right here. I had a 1942 right here. So it very well it could have been dropped in the 40s. That's awesome. 1942, Wheatie. Alright guys, on to the next. Okay guys, I haven't touched it and I don't know what it is. All I know is it's silver. It's a Mercurosi, or seated, huh? It is a rosy. There we go. 1964. I get so many 1964s. A ton of them. That is awesome. 1964 plain. Another silver. Third silver today. Great. Oh man, this ties for probably my second or third best day ever. Great guys. All right, I am happy. I have a big old silver smile on right now. Ring into two dimes. Alright, and I'm getting nothing but trash. Every other, all the 50s, 40s, everything is trash. The only thing I'm getting good stuff on is the high numbers. Except for the nickels. I've gotten a couple good nickels. But other than that, it's all been junk. Nice, guys. Alright, I'll see if there's anything else in here. I've got about 30 minutes left, so see what I can pull out in that time. And another Wheatie, 1951D. It is a little toasted, but still a Wheatie nonetheless. Alright folks, get some more.